Ver, 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 ver. Hear me, or I come mad.
Thank you. Not in the pearl. Angels beware, ye devils under mark. One, two, three, away!
every part of Master Trudy. Well, name the jewel, or he'll swap it off if you lay a cough or throw a stay against all England.
Aye, or he'll tap what it's had with any road. He's written on. We're opening with arms and riot, shaming the day of God. By Wallace Macdermotton. King or no king, will not endure it. And keep it whole.
bitter ban.
He must attack this day, walk like a soldier, or their sunset is life or death.
Tis God day, and prove his war till morning.
Honor with impious death is God's dishonor.
Is not the Son of Man Lord of the
first act of this world premiere performance of Merrymount by Dr. Howard Hanson, given by the Metropolitan Opera Company at the Metropolitan Opera House in New York City, and listened to that applause. The audience liked it. Well, we knew they would. Here are the principals taking their first call. Line of them. Wrestling Bradford, the preacher, Lawrence Tibbet, Praise God Duke, Louis D'Angelo, here they are again. That is Swarthout, there's plenty for you. William Clark has loved Brewster, they're all there. Alfredo Gandolfi is Broadrib, the captain. Here they are once again. Hi, how do they like it? Lady Marigold, you mustn't forget her. Judy Umberg in her beautiful dark green and riding skirt habit. And yellow and green plume hat. They take another bow. force in his many-colored suit. He's the clever Marek Windheim and Scrooby, the jovial Anglican priest, Milo Pico. And so Gower, of course, Edward Johnson. This is solo form by Mr. Tibbet as the preacher in his dark gray Puritan costume with a large white collar and white cuffs, knee breeches and big buckles on the shoes and a broad black buckled belt.
Thank you.
dancing in that scene was so colorful, the audience just wouldn't let the opera go on.
Thank you.
but to thy wedded wife.
I will.
And wilt thou have this man to thy wedded husband? How long has he both shall live?
Second act of Dr. Hanson's opera, Marymount. A beautiful scene. The Metropolitan certainly does things in a great way and with a lavish hand in this premiere. Here are the principals taking their first curtain call. Oh my, but Madame Jungberg and Mr. Johnson look fine in their rich robes. Mr. Johnson in his princely white and blue suit himself, and Madame Jungberg as Marigold in her beautiful fairy-like shimmering blue gown with a diadem and her golden flowing hair. And back to the future, of course, is there, Lawrence Tibbet. Scrooby, the Marymount Jolly Parson, Milo Pico. Praise God, Duke, Louis D'Angelo. They take another bow.
Alone with him.
banished, a prisoner, that she may bear no tales to London. My son, is this thy plighted troth unto my daughter? Burn and heal and
Thank you.
once more to win New England and welcome the throne within America. Bring the wrestling Bradford hither.
With silver flame, the hell I send you.
bandit and a witch.
goodness, we can say plenty about that, and I dare say it will be discussed a great deal. It was the fascinating, weird, wild, and wicked scene of the Devil's Den with its imps and devils and beautiful courtesans. The audience, I'm certain, got a great thrill out of the performance of that act. Then because Lawrence Tibbett and Madame Jungberg came on the stage for a bow, the first curtain call. Lawrence Tibbett is glad, but here they are again.
Thank you.
of this good curse. Mine eyes beheld a vision, ruled by the old upon the river God. The Lord, the great of hell, came with his blood of fierceness for an angel, to rip the Christian faith from our New England. state, deceive the poor by thy coming, and never go beside thee, let him that hath a fierce devil season hold thee. At the congregation,
hear those deafening cries of applause from the audience. And along with Madame Youngborg, we also had Gladys Swarthouse.